Welcome back to How to BIM and to a new Dynamo tutorial. In this video, I'm going to guide you through automating Revit element parameters using one special script. This script is beneficial for BIM modelers because it helps them both save time and ensure accuracy. It allows you to easily edit a lot of parameters at once by either dragging or changing values. So let's dive in. So the first thing to do is launching Revit and opening a project. This is the sample project I'm going to be using for this tutorial, and I made sure to add the link in the description below if you guys want to follow through. Before starting the creation of our script, let's talk about parameters in Revit more specifically. An element parameter is a variable associated with a building element. These parameters mainly define aspects like dimension, for example, length or width or height, or location like base or top levels or elevation. Parameters play an important role in customizing and controlling the behavior and the appearance of our elements within our model. So for the first script, I'm going to start with a simple example. We're going to choose a Windows family that has the same shared parameter, and we will try to create a script that will bulk edit these parameters. Then I'm going to show you how to create custom parameters and adjust your script in a way that will help you be able to edit these custom parameters or any other parameters you want to bulk edit with a Dynamo script. Now it's about time to go to Manage and launch Dynamo, create a new script. And let's go to our library or right click and type select model elements or simply model elements. Make sure to choose select model elements because we will be selecting multiple elements, not just one. Back to the library and we will choose set parameter by value. We have set parameter by name or set parameter value by name. We could choose either one depending on what we wanna do. Obviously, in the first input, we're gonna be linking it with the element output, and make sure to set your running to manual so we don't get a necessary error. When selecting your model, make sure that you can view your model in the background. Select the elements you want to use for the script and isolate them. A lot of you usually have issues at this point, so tell me if you do. Press on select and then simply select the elements in the model and link it to the element set parameter by name input. Now select one of your element, which is the windows in this case, and check the parameter you want to work with. Let's scroll down. For example, we could work with the head height. So in a parameter value, we need to enter our input in the format of a string. So let's right click and type string. And then copy the exact name of the parameter, which is head height. And then link it with the input. Next we have value, and it should be a variable. So let's pick, for example, a number slider. It would be easier to use. For the number slider, we could set the minimum and the maximum of value. For example, as a minimum, we could set 1 meter. I'm using the metric system here. And for the maximum, we could go with 9 meters because I think that's the highest level of this wall. And then link it with the input. Now we should run our script. Make sure that there are no errors. You can set it to automatic so you don't have to do it each time. And you could move your slider. And as you can see, all the windows selected are aligned. And you can see how easily you can choose what works best for your model by simply sliding your number slider. Now, assuming I'm working with this window family and I want to create my own parameter and then create a script to bulk edit that parameter myself, I could go to Manage, create a new parameter. Let's go below and create a new parameter. We'll just give it a random name. For example, add level, set the discipline, set the data type that I'm going to enter to this specific parameter. In this example, it's a distance. And then make sure to link it with the category that I want to work with, which is the window. When I press OK, I'll be making sure that any type of windows in this model will have this custom parameter that I just added. And there is the head level. And obviously this doesn't work on windows only. I could simply choose any other type of element or family, and I could add my custom parameter or whichever parameter I want to add to that specific element or category of elements. Now, back to Dynamo, there are multiple adjustments that you could do for the specific parameters that you want to work with. The first thing you can do is changing the node that you're using for the selection. For example, you could select model elements by category, not simply selecting all model elements. The most important thing to do to adjust your script to other purposes is obviously changing the parameter name based on the parameter that you want to bulk edit for your model. Let me know in the comment section which parameter do you think needs automation the most, and if you like my content, like, subscribe, share, and you could watch the rest of my Dynamo, Revit, and Navisworks videos. Thank you for watching.